Revolutionizing the culinary industry. He's been awarded the prestigious Mobile Travel Guide 5-star award at 2 different restaurants. His multi-award winning LA restaurant, Tuamek, has redefined refined dining in Southern California. A best-selling author, his own spice line, a James Beard finalist, 4 seasons of his own online cooking show, and one of the most recognizable chefs on television today. Please welcome Chef Luda Lefebvre.
Hello, guys. Hello, hello. People from Chicago. Voilà, welcome to my demo. Today is going to be a very, very, very easy demo for me because you know why? I don't need to cook. Well, this is actually a little stressful because I need to talk for 45 minutes. Yes, madam, I don't cook today. What I'm going to do, here, I use your price, huh? I know, let me find my knife. I don't have my knife.
Right behind you.
Huh? Oh, okay. So, today, yes, madam, I'm not going to cook. So today, I'm going to work on you on a knife skill. Yes, which is very, very, very important in cooking. At home, in the restaurant, it's all about, you know, knife skill, speed, and precision. You know, how to slice correctly an onion, how to dice garlic, I mean, cut bread, a vegetable, I mean, a citrus, all these things. I'm going to teach you that today, show you some example of what to do with knife, okay? First, talking about knife. First thing, I work with Global now for like, I would say 1 year now. And, you know, chef now, we get a lot of deals. You know, sponsor, they're paying us. And we're saying thing about what we represent. But I would say Global, when they contact me, I was very happy because I use them for like 30 years now. You know, as a chef when I was 25, I remember when I buy my first Global, it was in 96. It was a chef knife and I fell in love. Why? Because definitely the look, I think the look is pretty pretty nice. It's a good looking knife. What do you think? And trust me, 30 years ago it was pretty like a Jedi knife, like very Star Wars. Nobody was using a knife like that. So this is the color and the hole and all like that, you know? And the most important thing is, they're well, they're very good in the hand, you know, they're light, they're really like a good extension in my arm. You know, when I cook, you know, I don't, I mean, I cook for 35 years now, but I really don't feel my knife. You know, it's like a part of my body on my arm now. So the Global knife are very good for that, for the balance. And also, they're easy to maintenance. You know, knife, of course, is about sharpening. You know, you use it, pop, 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 pop. After you sharp, you know, in Japanese restaurant, you know, they always sharpening their knife. And sharpening, it's very, very important. You need to maintenance your knife. Yes, madam, it is. Promise you, madam. You have no idea on the restaurant. When I was very young, you know, I was working in the fancy restaurant. And yeah, you know, they give you a case of onions, you know, to dice or to clean, you know, and you need to go fast, you know, 30 minutes. So, you know, they will use the chef behind your, they fast, you ask, you know, to make sure you finish on time, you know. And trust me, man, it's all the time, I don't have that much money, I didn't know how to sharpen a knife, and yes, sometimes my knife was so bad, and it was take me more time to really peel the onions, and after chop the onions, you know, so it's very, very important the way you maintenance your knife. You can have the best knife, and, you know, if you don't sharp it, it's not going to work. It's like a car. You can have the best car. You don't put a hole, the car is going to broke. Anyway, so yeah, I work with Global for very, very long time. Global, sorry. And it's really a brand I really have in my heart. Okay, I'm going to talk a lot today about Global because in my contract, I need to say 30 times in 40 minutes. Global. So I did like 8, so it's good. Now I'm joking. Bon. I just create with a Global, I'm going to go quick, set, okay, quick by that, but that's my 4 knife I prefer to use in my kitchen. Like, I think you need it. I mean, this kind of knife, I really need it in the kitchen. This one is a little paring knife. I'm going to show you after, but with that, I do everything. I mean, this one is just really peeling, small dicing. It's a little bit of a French frou-frou, you know? We turn it, we take a potato, and we do a beautiful football ball. You know, bread, love bread knife. A lot of people at home don't have a bread knife. Bread knife, you know. You care, you know, it's like Japanese. They care the way they slice their fish. Guess what? In France, we care about our bread. we care about the way we slice our bread. And bread is all about the crust, as you know. And so you want to keep the crust on the bread. You don't want the crust to break, you know. So you need to have a good bread knife. And I know you all buy your bread, please slice, correct? Sure, you do it, but I can see that. You don't cook that much, you buy your bread slice already. Tell the truth, chef. Say yes or no? No, you know what? Utility knife. Love this knife. I use it a lot for vegetable. You know, serrated. It's very good. Very easy to don't need the maintenance that. You know, I'm going to show you after, but to cut a tomato, to cut leeks, you cut everything with that. It's so precise one more time, you know, but you can see the tomato is so easy to just slice it, you know. And of course, you know, the European style chef knife. I mean, that I use it for everything, okay? I clean fish with that, clean meat, you know, I mean, I do everything with that. It's really, for me, the knife to do everything, okay? So, let's go start. So, using knife, you need to have a good knife, make sure you have a good cutting board, okay, guys? Good cutting board, make sure the cutting board is very secure, you know? So normally, oh, you're a good chef, thank you, chef. I forgot about that. So make sure your for your cutting board don't move. We put this little piece of are you called chef in English? Rubber, yeah, rubber. Okay, but you can also use a wet towel. You take a towel, you put a little bit of water, and put it here. Put your cutting board, and trust me, like this, it don't move. You need to be safe. Okay, when you cut everything, you'd be safe, and make sure also you have a lot of space. I love to have space on my cutting board, you know. A lot of people leave a lot of things. No, I want all the space. So make things safe, easy to work with, okay? After knife safety, okay? Make sure, I don't know how you store your knife, but sometimes I see people taking in the drawer and cutting themselves, you know, or stuff like this. So be careful, you know. For example, I don't have a towel, but I see one thing in the kitchen, guys. One nice, so this is true thing. You know when you take your blade, okay? Easy thing to cut yourself. I know, it's a little boring, I know. So I don't cook today, sorry, madam. See that here, of course, you don't cut, but make sure you go like that. Okay, like that, here. I saw one cook one day, guys, just for you see, young kid don't know how to use a knife. This side, and go like that. Wow, it was pretty scary, trust me, hospital. But no, but knife safety, guys, it's very, very important, you know. Be careful the way you manipulate your knife, okay? Be careful with that, you know, don't talk like that, or, you know, be careful, you know. Especially if you have kids at home, or still, you know, any people around you, so be careful with that. So, we're going to start the demo, okay, guys? Huh? Okay, so, we're going to start with garlic, okay? I'm going to show you the garlic. So, you know, chef, what I need is just bold, thank you. So that, this is our paring knife. So paring knife, what I will do with paring knife? Definitely peeling thing, peeling garlic, okay? Garlic, okay? So the secret in the restaurant for garlic, I use a lot of garlic in my restaurant Petit Trois because we do like escargot. You know, with escargot, it's a lot of butter, garlic, parsley, and, you know, garlic. So you want to use fresh garlic. So fresh garlic, you mean from the farmer's market, you need to peel them, okay? But it takes very long time. So what we do, the night before, we put the whole head, you know, of garlic in cold water overnight, and the next day you strain the garlic, and it's way more easy to peel. Way more easy, guys. You know, the skin when you peel don't break. So easy. I mean, I say so easy, but it's way more easy, okay? So it's a little trick to do when you peel garlic, you know? But also, when you cook, you know, that's why you need to have a good knife, you know? Don't buy the garlic pre-diced or chopped already. I mean, that's terrible. That's really terrible. The flavor are not the same. You know, the way you slice the garlic, guys, you know, for do just a garlic butter, can really, really change the flavor of your garlic. If you don't chop the garlic the way they're supposed to be chopped, you know, the flavor of the garlic can be so different. It makes sense what I'm saying? It makes sense, guys? If you don't understand, ask me, okay, guys? I will repeat. Don't be afraid to ask me. So garlic, voilà. Do you see very well? Not very well, huh? No, it's okay, okay, good. One garlic, so hop, hop, one more here. Voilà, we'll peel it here, do a little incision here, and just that. But like I say, you know, put it in cold water overnight, and your garlic will be so easy to peel. So for peeling, we use a paring knife, okay? We talk about safety, we don't want to use this big knife. It makes no sense, okay? Cooking, dicing, you know, it's all about to use a proper knife. You know, I still see a lot of young cook, you know, in the kitchen, they still sometimes don't know how to use a proper knife for slicing a fish, for cut bread, for tourner a potato. So each knife have a specific, thank you, madame. Whew. Specific purpose, sorry. Thank you, madame. I have a surprise for you after. Please don't leave. Don't, because you helped me. Bon, garlic. So that is a very old garlic. You know why we know that, guys? Because you can see the germ is not green. You know, the thing inside the germ, you know. When you have young garlic, you have a green germ inside and it's no good, it's very bitter. So you make sure you take it up, okay? So for take it up, cut that here. Love it. Zen. So you take up the germ, okay, guys? Voilà. Okay? Well, we take it up, okay? Voilà. So, garlic. Very people are very specific the way to chop the garlic. Some they do like that, some they take a razor, machin. Like I have my friend, you know him, Anthony Bourdain. I always have a little fight with him on TV, I know that, but, you know, because he's whatever. But, you know, when he does the tomato sauce, he wants to slice this garlic very, very thin. He don't use a knife. He's using a razor blade. Yeah. Yeah, he cracked me up, the guys. It's so funny. Anyway, but I use a knife, you know, a paring knife. Oh, I forgot one thing important, guys. Hold your knife. Okay, sorry about that. But, like you have a big knife, you take the three hand like that. Three fingers, so three hands. This knife here, like that. Okay, you see, guys? So that you really grab very well. You hold the knife with that. You know, it's like you play tennis or ping pong, more tennis. But if you don't hold very well your racket, you're going to do a bad shot, you know? It's the same thing. You really hold your knife with that, just to feel comfortable, and here like that. Or you can go like that if you want. You know, but that, yeah, that's very good. Anyway, so I'm going to dice the garlic now, okay? So, or slice, I'm going to show you slicing garlic. So very, very thin, okay? So, yeah, it's going to be hard to show that like that, but you see, bon, you see the position on my finger, so it's like that. Make sure to hold very well the garlic glove. Yes, the garlic glove, yeah. 20 years and I still don't know. And after, so the blade, you see the blade? Do you see very well the blade like that, yeah? You see? So the blade really stay against my finger like that. And that's what's my finger are going to move, and at the same time, I'm going to move the blade. So that's how that the chef, you know, they are like this all the time. You're always so impressed because we are talking the same time, but actually you don't need to look what you're doing. Yeah, you don't see very well, I'm sorry. Next year, we'll organize better, guys. But you know, you see the blade? Just follow my hand, that's it. So that's how this chef, most of the time, we don't cut ourselves. You know? Don't do this mistake. Like to put the finger like that and go like that. Yeah, you're gonna cut yourself, no? But you know, yeah, sometimes you go fast and you cut yourself. You know? As the bread. When it's black, it's cooked. Voilà. No, we need very crusty. Hein? Yeah, more and more. Okay. So anyway, so. So yeah, so I'm taking my knife, you know, so the position here. So I hold very well my knife, okay? Position of the hand, like that. It's like, you do martial art? I do martial art. They call it the chicken move, you know, like you, I don't know, like kung fu. Like you can really hurt somebody like that. So chicken hand, chicken foot, or whatever. I just create something new today. And you put here, and now you can just cut. And so your finger knife, your finger move, your hand, and the blade too against. Voilà, so that is very, very thin slice. Okay, dicing now, dicing. Same position, again. So, very, very thin here. Okay, and then after, again, same position. So I'm going to show you now with the onions, so you can see better. So that this is really a minced garlic, very, very fine. But also you can do like that. Something very easy I like to do is like that. You take, you have garlic oil here. Hey, chef. I'll show you one thing. Touch the garlic clove. You go like that, so knife like that, fin like that, and chop it like that. You can use it also your garlic like that, you know. It's very easy. And after you just chop it. I want to see if you have a little bit of olive oil. Hey, chef, do you have olive oil? Please, guys. Sorry, guys. So, and after for chopping the garlic, so to go very fast. So just go quick like that. So, a little touch of olive oil, please. Olive oil. Olive oil. Okay, so you see, I'm going to go like that. So you put to chop garlic very fast. Knife, comme ça. Hand, comme ça. Là, we go like that. Okay, and like that. So you see the. See, you put pressure. Merci, chef. Thank you very much. So you put like that, or you can go like that. And, you know, people love it because it's fast, sound. But you know, the garlic go everywhere. See that? So how you do, madame? You know what we do? And we call it a little secret. So when you do like that, you know, it's very hard. You put your garlic like that, comme ça. Okay, you see? Bon, the garlic here. And I'm going to chop it, okay? So the garlic fly a little bit everywhere, okay? So what we do, madame? We go like that. Put the garlic here. And what I learned is you take a little bit of olive oil. Voilà. You just rub the garlic like that, comme ça. I'm starting to say like that because I say that like that all the time. So garlic comes like this, voilà. And now you can go. Now the garlic steak will get together. That's a little trick, but I like it. You can really chop it very fine so the garlic don't go everywhere. You can go like that. So that is really chopping. So you can go like that chopping, or you can go hand like that and just like that. Like this is more for the herbs normally, you know? You put the herbs like that, and voilà. So that is quick chopping. And you use a chef knife for that, okay? Voilà. Voilà, okay? Voilà, so now I'm gonna show you an onion so you can see the hand a little bit better. So we take an onion, paring knife, cutting board. You better to listen, guys, because after I'm going to ask you some question. We have a squeeze. I say quiz. Quiz. So you better listen. And you're going to win something. So you better just stay. You have something free after. That's what I keep all the time my people. Nobody leave my cooking demo because I say I give something free. So, madame? Okay, so now, so let's go serious. Okay, let's go walk a little bit. Hop, we peel the onions, so like that. Ah, I say like that all the time. Okay, we peel it, voila. So paring knife, okay. We peel with the paring knife, voila. Then I have my sharp knife, cut about half here, voila. And now we're going to dice it, okay. As you know, I'm sure French cuisine is very specific about the way we dice vegetable to do sauce and stock and bouillon. I mean, we're very, comme ça, French. You know, we want the food like that and the thing like that. I never understand. You have a mirepoix, which is big like that, and you have a dice. And they say for a stock, you need to put a mirepoix, but I'll be honest with you, I don't feel sure it don't change that much the flavor of the food, you know? But anyway. Bon, okay, comme ça, et on y va comme ça. So, voilà. So, ici. Voilà. I go one more time like that. Here. So, now, again, I'm going to do my chicken hand. Okay, put here to hold very well the onions. Knife, three hand, push here the finger and the index. Okay, and after you go, you know. And just the finger are moving, you see? Very easy, trust me. You feel like chef who are like so good, but practice, guys, and practice, it's easy. Voila, see, it's fast. I wish I can invite you to dice with me, but we cannot do that here. It's safety. Anyway, so maintenant I'm going to show you to do a little bit of suprême. What we can do with a utility knife. Because a lot of people don't really buy utility knife. When you go to the store, you're going to go to why buy? A knife like that, a chef knife, I will say. Perhaps a paring knife. And also maybe a fish knife, maybe, I don't know. you know, with a fish knife, it's pretty difficult to use. You need to know, but you know. So what I say, okay, supreme. So I'm going to do something, how to use a utility knife. So I use a lot utility knife, okay, in my house as a restaurant, okay. Citrus is one of my favorite ingredients, produce. I'm from France, of course, but I live for 20 years in California. And since I live in California, I become to have a passion for citrus. Love citrus. I mean, California is just so magical for that. So I'm going to show you how to do some with an orange and a lemon, okay? How to do supreme. Supreme, that's just a segment, to take the segment. I use a lot of segment in my cooking, you know, segment. So, I'm going to move that. Voilà, orange. So, again, stable. I go here, so voilà. Good, perfect, so you see the inside like that. So you make sure you cut enough. You don't want to cut the orange like that. Okay, guys, that is no good. We want to see the inside of the orange for the blade. So I'm going to go a little bit more over here, you can understand. Voilà. Okay, so now I'm going to piler à vif. That's a technique, French technique, piler à vif. You mean peel à vif, or whatever. Okay, so same thing, you hold like that. Okay, all the time, utility knife, okay? And we go like that here. I just follow the skin, see? And it's so easy with this knife because the movement is like that. It's more like when you cut wood with a saw. It's the same thing, you know? It's so easy to just cut the citrus, you know, will not destroy the shape of the orange. It's so smooth, guys, so smooth, you know? So smooth, look at this. I just follow the orange shape, and that's it, you know? And then after, what we do, so you see, you want to make sure you take up all the white, and you don't want to see any white. And then, after, we're going to take the supreme. With the supreme is good. If you do a salad, you can put some supreme like that, you know? You have any question, madam? No, you good? You have a question? If you have a question, you can ask me. Huh? Somebody should have a microphone, but... Oh, thank you very much, sir. You have any question about that? No, sorry, no, but... I don't really understand, so... So we take the supreme, comme ça, and we follow the... You see here, the little white membrane here? See? So we put the blade like that here. And here like that, comme ça, et hop. You know how to do it? You did that before? Merde. I'll show you something else, madam, okay. Oops! So very easy, okay, you follow. So voilà, I just go here. Voilà. What time is it now? So if they tell me I need to finish in 45 minutes, so I still have a lot of things to do, so. Hein? Oh, we have time, ça va. Good, so okay, guys, so very easy. Comme ça. Comme ça. Voilà, so ici, c'est là que saw. They cut the orange supreme. Very easy. Or you can go like that. Some people do like that. They go here, and after they follow like that. I think it's more precise. Tac, tac. I feel more safe like that. And after, make sure you take the juice, comme ça. Alors, et voilà. Voilà. C'était une orange. Maintenant, let's go to pineapple. I'm going to show you a pineapple. With the serrated knife, you know. But serrated knife is very good, like you can see, for fruit. I mean, I cut all my fruit with that. Pineapple, gros pineapple, gros. So, stable again, take a serrated knife. Like I said, you have way more precision with a serrated knife. The cut could be more clean than the chef knife. Chef knife, you know, is more like chef knife is more to go like that, you know? It's one, really one movement, you know, always like comme ça. I imagine it makes sense, I'm saying, but whatever. A pineapple, you want to go, you cannot just cut it like, comme ça, it's too dangerous. So, serrated knife, and you go just, right? And you just go like a saw. And it's cool, it's very easy. Voilà, okay? Puff, we turn here, and we go again here. Comme ça, voilà. And I think, again, same thing after, how to peel the pineapple. Same like a citrus. Put your blade here, follow the skin here, and just, voilà. See? Very easy. to cut like that. It's so easy. I don't feel my knife. It's like a, really an extension on a, well, first time it happened to me, guys. Some people just came now. Thank you. Hi. It's great. More people. It's a record. So you see, guys, voila, comme ça. And like I say, I feel more comfortable with that. I think it's more precision than just, because that is, this knife is not for that. You understand, guys? It's really to shop, you know? Yeah, exactly. So when it's more easy to go like that. I don't know how many times I say like that today. It's crazy, it's insane. I need to find something else. Anyway, so pineapple, you see, very easy. Voilà. Well, after, if you use it, guys, you can always go more a little bit and take up all the little black spots like that. Comme ça. I'm going to speak French, it'll be better. Comme ça. I'm tired to say like that. I'm going to check the bread. I want to use the bread. Yeah, I'm cooking a little bit today, madame. A little bit. I'm cooking bread. Anyway. Okay. Maintenant, la tomate. Les tomates. Love tomato salad. It's a very dish to do. You know, to, cooking is all about to pick the best ingredients. Okay. The first job for a chef is to go hunting. Hunting for the best ingredients. I will say in my job is really 80% of my time is the week, and I say that to my chef all the time, it's really to find the best. And after cooking, it's easy. If you have technique, good knife, after it's really a pleasure to just cook. But you know, tomato, you have a lot of different of tomato. You know, I think of like 150 different variety of tomato in the world. You know, some are more soft, more hard, you know, shape, color, taste. You know, but slicing a tomato to make a salad good, it's all about the way you slice the tomato. You know, it's like when you do a tomato sauce, you know, the way you're going to chop the garlic, it's going to change the taste of the sauce. And that is true. You know, if you dice a diced garlic with a knife, and if you put a food processor to chop the garlic, that's totally wrong. The sauce are not going to have the same taste. Don't be lazy. Use a knife. It's very important. Don't use this thing. A knife, guys. Knife, it's the best. You know, food processor will change the taste of some few things. Anyway, but tomato is like fish. Japanese, when they slice, you know, fish. So tomato. At the restaurant, we do a tomato sushi. So it's all about how to slice the tomato. And to slice very thin a tomato, still with a chef knife, it's very difficult. Very difficult, still like that. Trust me, I mean, I'm lucky because these knives are good, are very sharp, you know, so they cut very well. But it's still, it's a little bit hard to cut the skin, you know. But when you take a serrated knife like that, utility knife, it's, you can really have a good, precise precision to really slice the tomato the way you want. You know, it's way more easy like that. Like really like paper thin, you know? Like you can do like a carpaccio like that, you know, guys? Just put that on the plate. Okay, you put that beautifully on the plate like that. So you just, it's really seriously, guys, so easy. Just stay straight and that's it, you know? You put that beautiful, like different color, you know, of the tomato. But especially, you know, some people take up the skin. You know, tomato salad, some people take up the skin. Take up the skin, you cut a little bit across here like that, put in the water for 30 seconds, 10 seconds, ice water, and you peel. Okay? I love skin more. But people most of the time take up the skin because it's hard to cut. You know, but look, also like that. So comme ça. Hop, very fine like that. Comme ça, merde. So easy and so beautiful. You know, I mean, it's very like, it's very easy, this knife, to cut the fruit, cut tomato, it's a good vegetable knife also, the utility knife. You know, it's very easy to use. And you know what, when I like this knife too, guys, because you know why? No maintenance. You don't need to sharp it, it's always good. It's always good, it's not like the chef knife, you always need to sharp it after to use it, you know? You know, we sharp a lot our knife in the kitchen. Still a good knife, you need to sharp it, you know? But whatever. So you know, I love the utility knife for that. You know, Willie will love it. You can see, you know, it's good to cut everything. Well, it's not going to cut a piece of metal, okay, guys? It's not like this commercial we see on TV where they cut everything with that. They're going to cut the mixer, you know? No, not this knife, okay? It's great, but you don't do that, okay? We love our knife, okay? But no, utility knife, great knife. You know, a lot of people don't know about this knife, but it's really a knife like I always have in my bag when I travel. Okay, well, I say I'm going to do a nice salad tonight, some citrus, some tomato. Chef can use it after to do whatever she wants. Okay, now I'm going to show you the bread. Bread, like I say, bread is all about the crust. And what I see people do in their house or still in the restaurant, a lot of chefs, you know, my cook, when I ask them to cut bread, they use most of the time a chef knife. Not a lot of people have a bread knife. I don't know why. People don't buy bread knife. I don't know if because you all buy your bread pre-sliced. I don't know, but not everybody exaggerate, but a lot of people buy the bread pre-sliced, you know. But now America changed a lot. America, we have a lot of amazing bread now. A lot of good baker. It become almost better than France. Because French people now, they don't want to bake anymore. They're too lazy. They just want to work 8 hours. That's the French system. So now the baker, they don't want to work. And our young, new generation, they don't want to work. The artisanal job is less and less. In America, I feel like the opposite. That now everybody wants to be a chef, a baker. I mean, that's all that now we have more and more amazing bread in America because the new generation, they are very passionate about that, you know. But I was looking for the oven from my kitchen. So, poor God. Oh my God, guys. Unbelievable. So bread. So like I say, you know, bread, for me, bread is really, really, really about the crust. And bread is about the crust and to make sure, you know, when you hello, bonjour, Chef Lido, comment ça va, Chef Lido? I did this video, guys, you have a video about me who's coming soon with Elmo? Elmo, yeah, so cool. It was the best show I did in my life. It was so much fun, guys, so much fun. So much fun, I can't wait to see it. Anyway, so bread. Like at home, you're gonna do a lot, use a lot of croutons. You do a lot of croutons on bread. I love bread, I love to do bread, crumbs, croutons, everything is good with bread. Some butter and toasted with spice, and it's good. Or if you do crostini or bruschetta, you know, a tartare of beef on the toast or whatever. So, I hope the bread is going to break now, I hope so. So, you know, it's very difficult sometimes to get the perfect crouton. See, I put that here. You know, leaks. Voilà. Bon, most mistake I see is people smash the bread. So you don't want to smash the bread, you know, because that is not serrated, you know. So when you cut it, here we go. It's cutting well, it's great, it's sabotage. So, you know, when you just smash the bread, you break. I know I need to break it because, you know. So you see, guys, all the crust we missed here. I need to do it because, voilà. See, voilà. It's like, see, it's smashed. Voilà, perfect. That's exactly what I want. A lot of crust. All the crust is on the cutting board, guys. That's wrong. Okay, that's very wrong. In France, we are very specific the way we slice the bread. Okay, it's like the Japanese are very specific the way they slice their fish. So if you use a bread knife, like a real bread knife, you know, look at this. You have no breadcrumbs. Okay, tip off, un petit peu, voilà. But look, yeah, still have breadcrumbs. Gentle, chef. Voilà, much better. But my point is, I try to explain to you guys, okay, but sometimes when you use a knife like that, you're going to destroy the bread, like comme ça, tu vois? Like smash it, because it's not very easy to cut the crust, see? If you have a bread knife, like you don't smash the bread. That's what I try to explain to you in good English. You comprend? Yeah, I'm gonna see a big one now too. Yeah, gros pain, gros. Good, perfect. So yeah, like I say again, if you take a regular knife, what time is it, madame? 4:34. I have 6 minutes. Whew, I made it. So proud of myself today. It's not easy to talk for 45 minutes about a knife. I mean, you can try that at home, you see, guys. So, you know, I have nothing bad to say about the knife. You know, most people is in the newspaper. Newspaper, they talk a lot of the news because they're talking about bad thing on TV. I'm talking about the good thing. It's not easy. Anyway, see, if I want to cut the bread like that, it's going to smash it. See, it's just still, I break a little bit the crust. You know, you can watch. You know. If you take a bread knife, regardez. No, I mean, it's very, very smooth. Like, I mean, like, cutting the bread like that is very difficult. At the restaurant, we cut it like that. Voilà. And I'm very specific, you know, with my bread. But you want to have a nice slice. So, you know, you take a knife, a bread knife, and it's very easy to slice, you see? Voilà, okay? If I take a regular knife, which is a good knife, but it's not this knife is not the purpose. Purpose, no. The what? How you say in English? The purpose? Yeah, the purpose is to use this knife. It makes no sense. That is more for chopping, you know, dicing, you know. And it's, see, look, I don't exaggerate. It's hard. No, I don't exaggerate. It's just, it's very hard break the knife. You break the knife, you break the bread, you see? So again, that's what I mean, you know, you really want to use a good bread knife to slice bread, okay? It's great, perfect, guys. So that is for my salad for tonight. Huh? So now I'm going to show you how to tourner some vegetable. Tourner is a very, very French frou-frou thing. Because French people worry a lot about frou-frou. We love frou-frou. Love it, love it, love it. You know? So I'm going to clean my station. What I say to you guys, I say when you use a knife or when you walk, you need to have a clean station. All the time, guys, clean up. That's what I say to my kid, clean up, clean up, clean up, all the time. My son cook a lot, maybe more than me at home, because I'm never home. The mistake is cooking very well, but he never clean. Not very well, not like me. So because you came later, madam, I know, I'll show you. Make sure when you cut, safety first, guys, okay? Safety, we put a little bit of rubber thing here. Put your cutting board, and like this, it don't move. Make sure your cutting board don't move like that, okay? So cooking, dicing, using knife, is all about safety. Bon, maintenant, I say tourner, I'm going to show you how to do a chiffonade, okay? Like a French chiffonade and an Italian chiffonade. I have my friend called Valérie Bertilini. No, she's on TV, you know? Yeah, she tried to be a chef. She tried. She invited me in the show because she needs a real chef. Hello. Thank God she's not here. She's stealing my job. Seriously, I love it. She's a good friend. I always say, why are you on TV? I cook better than you. That's not fair. That's not me, seriously. It's like if I become an actor now. You know, she's an actress and she's teaching cooking. She should teach acting. Anyway, so tourner is a very, you're right, you agree, madame. You know, when you take a big potato like that, that is the biggest one. Voilà. That I'm going to make a very French, French ball, okay, like a football, American football, okay? So, look, guys, you cut the thing like that, comme ça, 4 pieces, okay? Voilà. For that again, paring knife, okay? What kind of brand we use? Huh? Chef, that's for you, this one. I'll get to you after. After, I need you now. I have 3 more questions. Sorry, Erika, I'll give you all the knife. I'll give you money after. Bon, football, I'm going to tourner, okay? You've been to France, guys? Yeah, you see how we can be so frou-frou with our food, and you know? So tourner is to take a long time ago, like 30 years ago, French food was very frou-frou. You want the food to be very, very beautiful, you know? You take a potato and you make a little thing like that, you know? So tourner, so I don't know how to explain that, but I'm going to make look the, regardez. So we all like that. And we're going to just make the potato very nice. In France, this kind of potato, we call it a pomme cocotte. I don't know why we say pomme cocotte, but that's a pomme cocotte. Okay, so you really make the potato the shape of the football. Wow, it's a long time, guys. I did not do that. Thank God I have a good knife. Huh? Voilà. Yeah, seriously, guys. Oh, I lose my little, and I start again, one more year. I wish you can try to, I cannot invite you to try it because, I don't know. Regardez. So we just, et ça we can do with the carrot, with turnips, with carrot, with turnips, with icon. So that it was, so trust me, when I learned how to cook, this tournée potato was the trend in France. So I was taking carrot, turnips, kohlrabi, and just make all this food like very, very French frou-frou like that. We got tournée. So now I'm going to show you a chiffonade. How we do chiffonade in France. So I'm going to do two chiffonades. I'm going to ask you what the one is French and what the one is Italian. My friend Valérie Bertelloni is what she showed me. So voilà. So. Oh putain. No, you don't trust me, huh? Nobody was care, huh? Nobody care. So voilà. But hey guys, seriously, woolly cooking, dicing with amazing knife is pretty, you really enjoy. Like it's very, 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 very easy. You know, want that 1 year. So you see, huh? You take all your leaves like that, comme ça. Hop. Voilà. 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 Okay. And after you just, oh no, she was comme ça. Voilà. So, one is French, one is Italian. Who wants to tell me who's French? Huh? Yeah, first one, you get a knife, madame. Voilà, you get this knife. Voilà. That's for you. Ça, c'est pour toi, celui-là. Voilà, I have two more knives. What can I do? What's the name of this knife? You get it, you're good. One more, my best one. What do we do with bread knife, guys? Okay, hein? Good job, madame, voilà. Voilà, et voilà, guys. What time is it? One more, guys. Licks, let's go. Make sure you take your knife, hein, guys. Licks. Julienne, I'm going to show you a nice julienne of licks. Licks. Boom, go like that. Comme ça, sorry. Comme ça. Voilà. Comme ça, comme here. Voilà. So that after you see the licks, so you see all the layer of licks we have here. It's pretty cool, huh? So in France, we use that a lot to do julienne, and we fry it after. Comme ça. We take up this one here. We don't want this part here. It's a little bit. So we will add that, and comme ça. So we can, hop, make sure to keep the licks like that. Madame, no cell phone was allowed here. It's like in my restaurant, no picture, no phone. Very French. This side, no phone. It's good. I mean, no, it's not easy to cook with the flash. Okay, on y va. Et là, c'est une julienne. So ici. I mean, so see, it's very, very easy. And my point is, make sure, you know, to make sure to take 10 minutes and really sharp your knife. You know, I mean, if you buy a global knife also, we have a set, you know, a chef, Mimo was here today doing a demo about sharpening. And I think he's doing one again tomorrow. Huh? He's doing a demo, chef Nemo about sharpening? No, that's great. So. But no, but you can look on my website, on Ludo, I don't know what's the website. No, le fait à la maison, whatever. But just type my name and a sharpening knife. But make sure to sharp your knife. Okay, maintenance your knife, guys. Yes. And it's not that difficult, I promise you. You buy your stone, you know, and you just... Huh? No, you don't sharp a knife, no. No. Just send it to me and I'll sharp it for you. So no, sharpening is very easy. You have a stone, you know, it's about an angle, and after you just go back and forth like that. And just do a few times, just practice. After, it will be so easy for you guys. And it's so enjoyable to cook when your knife is sharp correctly. You have no idea how I get so mad in the kitchen. Most of the time, we're always behind. We're never ready. We're running for everything. And when you don't have a good knife, you're losing so much time and precision, you know, how to make a good food. Dicing is so important in cooking. Using a knife, pick a good knife, it's a big deal. You know, you have this knife for all your life. I have my Global for 30 years, and I promise you, they don't move this knife. I mean, they don't change. You know, they don't get white hair or get wrinkled or nothing. They're always the same. Yeah, I use them for like 30 years now. They are very good, and they are very affordable. You know, brand knife now, it's very expensive. You have some Japanese, this knife is made in Japan, and it's very affordable. Everything from Japan is so expensive. You see that? Oh my God, everything from Japan is so expensive. Everything. Everything. It's true. I mean, it's because it's quality. Global is fully affordable. Seriously. Yeah. And it's a good knife. Yeah. Really like it. The problem with Global is you have so many knives, you don't know what to take sometimes. So the easy way, just buy the box of Lido. That's the best knife you need in your kitchen. No, but it's true. I mean, I know, Mimo is Japanese, and he creates the line of Global, and I realized after when I did the boss, oh my God, they are Japanese knife, I did not put any sushi knife. But anyway, that's the knife I really like to use. What do you? And yeah, good, thank you guys. Merci, thank you very much. Huh? Thank you guys. Thank you for staying, I really appreciate it. Come to pick your knife. Okay.
Thank you so much.
I'm going to clean it for you quick, guys.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Yeah. You want to clean it for you, guys? You want to clean it?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, madame, yeah. We don't